May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Everything has a cost to it, doesn't it? I was raised, quote by quote, as an army brat to remember the cost of the freedom that we enjoy as Americans. When my granddad fought in the Battle of the Bulge, crossed the bridge at Monongahela, my uncle died on the battlefield of Philly between Salerno and Milwaukee of World War II. And Dad was too young then to serve. He was still a teenager, but later he did join the army. I come from this long line of army folks. And he served two tours in Vietnam and Korea, and he survived. But sadly, his college roommate, Fred, was killed in Vietnam, one of his best friends. So much blood spilled. After retirement, Dad decided he was going to give up some of his blood too, and just last week he gave his 200th claim to the Red Cross. He said, "I always admired the Red Cross. It's the least I can do." But today I wanted to talk about the cost of blood spilled. It's a heavy subject. It has to do with our Eucharist. Imagine for a moment that you're the rich and powerful King Herod Agrippa, and you're the ruler of, at the appointment of the emperor in Rome, you rule over Galilee and Judea. And one night you're hosting a dinner party for all the regional leaders, and what you really want to do is watch your fetching stepdaughter dance. You feel attracted to her, and you want to show her off to all your guests. After all, it's your birthday. against a symbol of hatred, a flag that symbolizes oppression. How tragic for all of us that such a cost had to be paid before we confronted the symbol of hate that we have largely ignored over the years. So, there's this end of this. This week, something good had to come out of this. What could it be? Well, just yesterday, the flag did come down, didn't it? It did happen. Not only the flag, the flagpole came down, the fence around the flagpole came down. It all came tumbling down at the State House there in Charleston. And though the removal of that flag will never bring back the life of a Reverend Clemente painting or the other eight victims who died at that AME church that night, it did feel like some indication of the life that was sacrificed. But it's such a cost. And how many people have already died? And how many more innocent people will be killed by those who have not, who shouldn't have died? color, by economic status. A world drawn to glittering things. What step can we take? To be an agent of grace and truth,